Claims of intimidation and bullying at the West Australian Aboriginal Affairs Department are raising questions over the agency's culture and ability to protect heritage. Tonight we hear from the union, which represents the employees of the department. It confirms allegations of bullying were first reported to the CPSU back in 2012 at secret meetings held in Perth.
The accusations of bullying came from our whistleblower, Mary. The former employee painted an upsetting picture.
My experience was very intimidating, very bully-like behaviour. Being told to do things over and over again until what they wanted was achieved. It felt really intimidating. Knowing morally what I was doing was wrong, I was still, I'll say it the way it is, I was intimidated to change it.
Now the union responsible for the employees at the Department of Aboriginal Affairs has confirmed it has been hearing about this behaviour since 2012.
Individuals contact us on an individual basis, but we've also had members as a group come to us and want to meet to talk about what options they have and raise these issues with us.
The feeling of powerlessness among employees swelled to the point a group met secretly with the union.
We've met with members, and our members at some point got so frustrated that there was nothing they felt was being done about this situation that they asked for us to come and meet with them as a group.
This bullying and intimidating behaviour in the workplace was addressed by the group of employees too fearful to raise it within the department.
People have reported to us that they feel intimidated. They feel that if they speak out or they are trying to offer constructive criticism, trying to improve something, but that their feedback and their suggestions aren't welcome, that they're seen as unwanted and that they then feel that there'll be some form of covert retribution.
A follow-up survey was then carried out between the union and the employees.
If we survey people, we find that 70% of people have either experienced bullying or have observed that happening. That's actually about a cultural issue within the organisation usually. That's a high result. And we did talk with management at the time. Unfortunately, our members felt very little had been done constructively by management.
Employees have told NITV News that the intimidation was directly linked to the approval of development applications. The pressure to okay applications despite concerns over heritage protection was constant. The Department of Aboriginal Affairs has been contacted for a response about what it intends to do to improve this toxic workplace. Craig Quartermaine in Perth, NITV News.